what we'd be building today. So you can increase, decrease, and you'd be able to go to a new page and you see the state, come back, you decrease again, go to a new page and see it. Okay, so that's what we're going to
make
build.
Sure you go ahead and install the plugin, which is Flutter BLoC, and then do pubget.
Since we are using BLoC, and in BLoC you will use classes to manage your states. So we have two classes over here. So this is our base class, and in base class we have a variable named counter, and this is the value that we want to maintain the state for. And we have another class, and this class extends our base class. So later on we will see we call this class to initialize our state variable value from our blocs. In BLoC, user interaction causes events, and those events eventually causes state change. So for this reason over here we'll declare events classes. The first class is an abstract class, and the second class extends the abstract class. The name of the second class is increment, because as we click on the button we want to increase value. Of course you can name it anything. Now events are referred as classes in blocs, so we'd be calling these classes from our UI. Since we are using blocs for state management, we have to combine our blocs and states in a class. And here we created a class named counterBlocs, and this class extends the BLoC class, which means the BLoC library over here, and it takes events and states, the one that we create. Now over here I have this constructor, and this constructor must call superConstructor, and as we call it, we initialize the state by calling this initialState class. From our UI, using this counterBlocs class will cause events. Now events are registered inside the body of this constructor, and they're registered using word on, and then you call your event, and after that you have to pass event and emit object. With emit object, actually you can change the state of your variable. Since we are using BLoC over here, so we can access the state object, and state object will refer to the counter variable that we created early, which is over here. And since we are going to increase the value, so we do plus one. Now we are in our main.dart class because we want our children to access the BLoC and its value and the state. So that's why we wrap this material app using BLoC provider. And at the same time, we inject this counter BLoC class so that our children can access them from anywhere they want in the widget tree. And because we want our UI to be reactive, that's why we wrap our column over here using BlocBuilder. Because of BlocBuilder, we can use the state object, and then we'd be able to change the state of the variable on a button click. For button pressed over here, we are causing an event to be triggered. So that's why we do BlocProvider.of, and then you have to pass your blocs, the blocs that we created. At the same time, you have to mention the context type. On that context, we add an event. And inside this text, we have the state object. Because of the state object, we can access the counter variable. Let's go ahead and save it, and we see 6. You can click on them, it would increase even more. Now we'll go ahead and create another event, and right below it, just create a new class, and you can name it anything. And in this case, we are naming it decrement because we want to decrease the value. Now here is our elevated button, and inside this, we are going to call another event, which is called decrement. But if you go ahead and click on them, nothing happens because we didn't register this event in our blocs. And all we need to do, change the name of this event, and then plus becomes minus. Now we'll go ahead and create a button to be able to go to next page. This is our new page, and over here we are getting the BLoC. To get the BLoC, all you need to do blocprovider.of, and you pass the blocs that you created and the context. Then you can save it in a variable as you want. And because you can access this variable, once again you can access the state and the related value. Here we see click. So your value and the states are persisted everywhere.